Praise the Lord. Amazing grace. Grace can move the mountain of guilt and shame. Grace can flood your days in desert with streams of living water. Grace can bring you through the fire of adversity without the smell of smoke being upon you. Grace is unmerited favor of God. You can't buy it, you can't earn it, you can only receive it, because God is so glad to give it. Grace is an ocean without a shoreline. Grace has no limits. God's grace will give you a new beginning. God's grace is greater than your sin. God's grace is greater than of all your faults and failures, and it is the only thing that can truly heal. Why is grace amazing? When we look into the word amazing grace, and the word amazing is talking about the thing that are unusual. When it is amazing, it is not average. When it is amazing, it is something that the average person can't do. Bible says in Ephesians chapter 2 verse 8, "For by grace you have been saved through one action, faith." So when you put your faith in Jesus Christ, you have grace. The only ability to receive grace is through faith. Grace is the free gift of God. Jesus told the parable about a shepherd that had 100 sheep, but one of them went astray. The shepherd left the 99 and went looking for the one which is lost. Likewise, you can be in sin. The grace is looking for you. You can be working in the wrong kind of place. Grace is looking for you. You can be discouraged, depressed, about to give up on life. The good news is, right now, grace is looking for you. You have made mistakes. You are not where you want to be in life, but the grace of God is looking for you. God leaves the 99 and come after you by saying, "I'm not mad at you. I'm madly in love with you. I'm not holding anything against you. I'm not keeping a record of your mistakes. I'm not even interested in your past. I'm interested in your future." It doesn't matter to God where you have been. It's matter to God where you are going. That's why He is coming after you. That's why He won't leave you alone. His grace will never give up. He loves you too much. You can't run out from the grace of God. You can't do too many wrongs to keep it away. You can't turn away too many times. God's grace will keep coming and saying, "I have got something better. I have got forgiveness. I have got mercy. I have got a resurrection. And I have got a new beginning." If you shake off the guilt and condemnation, start making the choice that honors God, He will bless you in spite of your mistakes. He will make something great of your life in spite of your past. God never gives up on you. Don't give up on yourself. Receive the grace, believing that there is something amazing in your future. The scripture says, "God came to seek and to save those that are lost." Seek means to go after, to pursue, to track down. All you have to do is to receive the grace of God. It is a free gift. The price has already been paid 2,000 years ago. It's not a goodness, it's God's goodness. God has made us worthy. That's why it is called amazing grace. You don't deserve it. You did not earn it. It's just the goodness of God. God's grace is amazing. We are saved by grace. God's undeserved favor. And we live by grace, which is also God's power in our lives to do what we could never do in our own strength. And it is all because God is love, and He loves us unconditionally, constantly, and completely. In God's garden of grace, Even a broken tree can bear fruit. Have faith. Keep believing. Trust God. Receive the amazing grace. Thank you.